Welcome to the show.
No,
we are very fine. Thank you very much. Welcome to the show, and thank you very much for making time to get back.
Yeah, always available for the people. Uh-huh. This is the show for the people, especially the younger generation, those who don't know anything about the legends. I think it's important for them to understand and know how much we've contributed towards the game.
You've contributed immensely, you know, towards the game. Besides playing football, besides being an administrator in the game of football, when you were here the last time, we spent a lot of time speaking about your days at Orlando Pirates. We never really had enough time to speak about your exploits overseas. So I would perhaps, you know, the viewers will help us, you know, in terms of the telephone calls and the emails that they are going to send through to the show whilst we have you. But I would really, really like to now focus on the birth of the team known as Jomo Cosmos today. When did you get this idea that one day I want to have a team of my own?
Actually, it was during my last days at Orlando Pirates, you know, because I stopped playing in Toronto in 1982 after I broke my ankle when I was supposed to go and play for Juventus. I went back, but the last 2 years, I had lost a lot of interest, and I felt that it was time for me to come back home and start a business. I made an approach to Orlando Pirates during that time. It was the late 60 Mali and, you know, during the era of Mabaso and them. And I was not allowed to get Pirates. They told me that Pirates belongs to the people.
You wanted to buy Orlando Pirates?
I wanted to buy Orlando Pirates, yes.
And that move fell apart?
It fell apart because they said Patson also would like to buy Pirates.